Bom dia a todos. Good day, everyone. Today's class is going to be about verbo ser and estar. That is, to be. You have two verbs in Portuguese for to be, which we don't have in English. So, ser is to be in permanent nature and estar is to be in temporary nature. So, I've already given you the notes of verbo ser, which is to be in permanent nature. I will conjugate the verb so you are familiar with the pronunciation. Alright, so verbo ser is conjugated as follows. Eu sou, tu és, ele é, ela é, você é, nós somos, eles são, elas são, vocês são. That is, I am, you are, he is, she is, you are, which is formal, we are, for masculine, they are feminine, and you are plural. Alright, so now I have put M, F, and PL in brackets, which M stands for masculine, F for feminine, and PL for plural. Okay, so quando é que se usa o verbo ser? When to use the verb ser to be in permanent nature. Nacionalidades. What is? That is nationalities. Okay? Profissões. Professions. Estado civil, which is your civil status. Origem plus de and the substantivo, which is your place of origin, from or of, plus the noun. Posse, de plus the substantivo, which is place of belonging, of and from, plus the noun. Tempo cronológico, chronological time, that is horas, dias de semana, datas, so that is time, days of the week and dates. Matéria, when we're talking about matter, for example, you're talking about stone, you're talking about wood, you will use the verb ser, because these are permanent nature, they don't change very quickly. Situação geográfica, sujeito fixo, which is geographical location of a permanent subject. Substantivos, that are nouns, and adjetivos, which are adjectives. I will give you a few examples. For example, I'm using the verb ser for me. Eu sou. I will say, eu sou a René Pinto. Okay? Which is, I am René Pinto. Oh, você é professor. You are a teacher. Or, eles são rapazes. Or, eles são meninos. Which is, they are boys. You have two words for boys, which is either rapazes or meninos. Then we have, nós somos amigos. We are friends. Ela é de Goa. She is from Goa. Vocês são os meus alunos, or you can say, vocês são os meus estudantes. You are my students. Again, like we had for boys two words, you also have for students two words, that is, alunos or estudantes. Now you have noticed, you may have noticed that we have said meus here, because we're talking about when there is more than one boy in this group of a mixed group of people, you will always go to the masculine plural. Okay? Immaterial how many girls there are in that group or how many women there are in the group. If there is even one male representative in the group, it always goes to the masculine plural form. Moving on, we have verbo estar. Now, verbo estar is to be again, but this is temporary nature. Okay? I will conjugate the verb estar for you. So that is, eu estou, which is I am, tu estás, you are, ele está, he is, ela está, she is, você está, you are, formal, nós estamos, we are, eles estão, they are, in masculine, elas estão, they are, in feminine, and vocês estão, you are, in plural. Okay, again, masculine, feminine, and plural, I have mentioned below. Alright, so now, when I say você and tu are both you, and I mentioned você is you formal, I mean formal in the sense when you're referring to people who are older to you. For example, your parents, your teachers, grandparents, or someone you've never met before, you will always be formal initially, even though you may know the person or the person may be related to you, or only after the person mentions to you that you can treat the person as tu, it is a more casual situation, alright? So, until then you will use você, clear? So, quando se usa o verbo estar, when do we use the verb estar to be temporary nature? Para exprimir estados físicos e psicológicos ocasionais. Now, to express physical and psychological state of a person which is temporary, occasional status, okay? Then, you have exprimir a localização temporária de seres e objetos to express one's temporary nature of objects or people. For I have given examples later. Then, estar mais com mais substantivos para estados físicos e psicológicos. To be, the verb to be, plus the preposition with, followed by the noun that is used for physical and psychological state. Também para exprimir o tempo atmosférico, to express when you're talking about the weather, the climate, okay? Because it can change all of a sudden. So, the next one is verbo estar mais o a e o infinitivo do verbo para exprimir ações ocasionais que decorrem no momento que fala. Again, you use verb to be, estar, plus to or at, and the infinitive of the verb that you want to use to express occasional actions that occur at the moment that one speaks. Okay? So, for example, using the verb estar, I will use, for example, I want to say, I am in Margam. I will say, eu estou em Margam. Or, tu estás a estudar. Are you studying? Third one, ele está a trabalhar no seu quarto. He is working in his room. Fourth, nós estamos a ensaiar para o concurso. We are practicing for the competition. Fifth, está muito quente. It is hot. So, when you want to express the weather, you will use this verb estar because after some time it may be cool. Then you can say, está mais fresco. It's a little more fresh now, more pleasant now. Another example is, vocês estão com saudades da escola? Are you missing school? So, these are temporary in nature. Okay? Further on, I have also given you the differences together so you can compare the differences. For example, ser, you will use to talk about things of permanent nature. Natureza permanent is permanent nature of the person. For example, a profissão, the profession of the person. The person, what do I mean by this? Now, when you're talking about the profession, now ser, you have to remember, is permanent in nature in the sense that these things don't change over time. For example, I am a girl. Tomorrow I cannot be a boy. Or tonight I cannot be a boy. So that the gender of the person doesn't change over time. So that's when you will use ser, okay? Profession. I can't be a teacher right now and a student tomorrow. Or a student right now and a doctor tomorrow morning. Right? So that is when it's of a longer duration, you will use ser. Nationality. Nacionalidad. Also, you are always, now, many of you might say, but teacher, I have Portuguese passport. Then I'm a Portuguese person. But no, you are always Goan, but you have an additional nationality, which is Portuguese, for example. Okay? Then, características físicas, your physical characteristics. Now, you want to say, someone is tall, someone is short. You would say, ele é alto, ele é baixo. But you won't say that someone is suddenly tall, right? Then, next, to express things of properties of which are permanent, like esta pedra é de granito. This stone is of granite. Again, it can't be of marble and then suddenly granite. Okay. Then este disco é muito bom. This CD is very good. So you're expressing that the quality of that is very good. All right. Then you will use the verb ser. On the other hand, we are saying we are looking at star, estados físicos, like I said. Your physical status. What do you feel? Estou bem, obrigado. Como estás? How are you? Right now, I'm good. Later on in the day, I might feel sick or I might have a stomach ache. So then you can express using the verb estar. Alright? So for example, estou com muita sede. I'm very thirsty. Or, o Pedro está doente. Pedro is sick. Alright then, next example for estar is localização temporária. Someone's location. For example, I want to say, I am in the market. Estou no mercado. Neste momento, at this moment, I am in the market. Or later on, ele está na escola. He is in school. Or, os pais estão em casa. Are your parents at home? So, you can use the verb estar because that moment, are they at home? Or, are you in the market? Or, I am in school. You can use the verb estar. Okay? Next one is using, for sale, we are using time, date and days of the week. Hoje é terça-feira. Today is Tuesday. Okay? You cannot change that. Or, são 20 horas. It is 20 hours if you literally translate it. But since in the Portuguese we use the 24-hour clock, we are talking about 8 p.m. So, it is 8 p.m. You say, são 8 horas. And exprime a localização das casas ou localidades. For example, you're talking about the location of your house or the location of your school or some sort of geographical location you're giving which is permanent. Now, for example, you want to say a livraria liceu é ao lado da loja. The library liceu is beside the shop. Or a minha casa fica perto dos correios. My house is next to the post office. Alright? So, é, you will not use estar because your house doesn't move. Alright? You can probably change your house. But your house is always going to be there. So, a minha casa é perto dos correios. Correct? Now, moving on to estar, you have o tempo atmosférico. Como está o tempo? We're talking about o tempo here can also be time. But we're here, specifically we're talking about the weather. Tempo here is weather. So, como está o tempo? How's the weather? Está frio. It's cold. Or, hoje estão 35 graus. Today it's 35 degrees. So, it's very hot. So, you want to say, you're talking about the weather. You will say it's very hot or it's cold. You will use estar. Okay. Then, verbo estar mais and o infinitivo. We're talking about estar, to be, to when you're doing something. You want to say, I am studying. Eu estou a estudar. I am studying. Or you want to say, for example, eles estão a jogar no pátio. They are playing on the ground. They are playing. So when it's present continuous, you will use estar plus a, that's the preposition a, to or at, followed by the infinitive of the verb. Alright? And the last part of estar is estar plus com plus o substantivo, okay? Which is estados físicos ou psicológicos. You're talking about physical or psychological state, which is now. Suppose I want to see, I've got a stomach ache, for example. So you say, estou com dores de barriga. Or, ele está doente. Or, está com frio. Ele está com frio. Estar, conjugated according to which person you are referring to. Com, which is with. And he has a cold, you want to say. Or he is cold. Now, you remember very importantly, you cannot literally translate every statement that you use in Portuguese. Okay? Because the meaning changes depending on the situation. Alright? So, that's about it. So, when we're using the verb say, remember it is things of permanent nature or longer duration, and estar is when you're using it up for temporary things like your what you're feeling, how the weather is, where you are currently or temporarily, and also when you want to talk about someone's physical status. Okay, and when you're talking about say, where you're talking about nationalities, your age, your civil status, you're single, you're a couple, you're married, you're divorced, whatever, then you will use the verb sale. Okay? And also when you're talking about, for example, material like stone, wood, glass, then you will use the verb sale. Alright? That's about it for today. And we will move on to the next topic after some time. Thank you.